Hey, Levi. All right, this video is like the seventh video on a series of videos working on putting a peaked roof over this flat roof building. So far I've covered putting up all this metal work, setting these precast concrete slabs for this floor, and I just finished pouring this concrete last night. All right, so I'm all set to start putting up the roof on this thing, and that's gonna be so nice once there's a roof on this, because then the whole thing will be like inside. Because the reason I'm doing this is this flat roof leaks, and yeah, it is fixable, but this gives me a whole nother level up here too, which is nice. All right, so let me get all the materials ordered, get them unloaded, and start putting them up. This is gonna be a bunch of LVLs doing this on this section. That's gonna be simple. This is gonna be just peaked like that. That's gonna be real easy. That's gonna be outside there. And there'll be roof, you know, over where I'm standing here as well. But this dormer here, that's going to be kind of a little bit complicated. There'll be a bunch of like compound miter cuts to make that all work. But it's going to look real nice once it's all done. All right, so let's get the materials and get to work. Okay, so look, gotta go down a hair. Perfect. Just finished welding that in. Thank you.
Oh yeah, check that out. That's way up there.
Man, that's pretty high actually. That's cool. Alright, cool. I wasn't even looking for this, but I saw it on the side of the road with a for sale sign on it. And the price seemed right. It needs a little work, but nothing crazy. This 3/4 inch plate. Don't let that all build up on there, because then it can't like expel more and then it breaks the bit. All right, I just got finished doing all that welding, but the idea with this is that it will transfer some of the load, well, it will take some of the load off of that point there and put it onto these walls, which these are all solid concrete. And I'm gonna do that for every one of these posts. So for example, I already started this one here. And this one here, I'm gonna do it like this. So you can see now this post, now it's also got the load going into this wall, which this is a solid wall. Well, right there, it's about over the corner of the shipping container, which is invincible, but it's also on top of that solid concrete wall, which also has another 6x6 column in that corner going to the ground. So that point there can take a ridiculous amount of weight, considerably more than will ever be on this thing. And I'm gonna do that there, there, there. And I already did it here too. You know, that wasn't necessary, but I like it. I think it looks cool too. Just welding in these braces on the ends. It probably doesn't even need those, but I feel like it strengthens the whole thing considerably. This is offset from that post there, and to do the support underneath it kind of puts it at a weird angle, so I'm just gonna do this. This is where I'm at on this project. It's been at a bit of a standstill for the last 2 weeks because I kind of want to make a little bit of a change with this roof. So I started putting up the roof. These are, I think, 16-inch LVLs, 2 foot on center. The plan was to put these up and then put metal roofing just like that building has there over top of it. And I'm sure that would have been fine forever, but that's not quite what I want to do with this building, is just put a normal roof on it. My concerns were, one, I want everything on this building to be completely fireproof. Obviously having a bunch of wood that's all glued together is not fireproof. And plus that roof is strong too, like it's obviously built to code, but I want this thing to be able to withstand any amount of wind. You know, I don't want like, oh, here's a tornado every 20 years or something that rips the roof off of it. I want to put this building up so it will never burn, and so I will never question any type of extreme weather event, whether it be high winds or anything like that. All right, so I had the engineers who designed the project with me come out to the site. They were happy with everything that was done so far, but I told them the change I want to do to it. So they just got back to me. I'm able to take down these 16-inch LVLs and replace them with 12-inch steel I-beams. It's gonna be 12 inch by 16 pounds per foot. That's kind of how they, so it's called a W12 by 16. That's how they size I-beams. And I'm gonna be able to get away with 4 foot on center, which is nice because that's half as much work. And then for the roofing, I'm just gonna put 8-foot by 20-foot steel sheets over top of the entire thing. It's gonna be a crazy amount of welding, but then I'll have like an incredibly strong roof, which should last absolutely forever. Got these Kevlar sling protectors. It's nice and easy getting stuff up here when the driveway's not covered in snow. All right, check this thing out. The Bobcat wouldn't touch this. Just tip him right over. This thing picked it up. Not easy, barely picked it up, but it got it. Let's see how much weight this is. These beams are really easy to calculate the weight because the way they sell them is pounds per foot. So these are W12 by 30. So that, oh, it says right on them, 1,200 pounds, but it'd be 30 pounds per foot and they're 40 feet. So we got 2,400 pounds. These are W12 by 16, so these are 16 pounds per foot, and they're 40 feet. So these are 16 times 40 each. So 640 pounds for each beam. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sorry, so 640 pounds times 8, 5,000 plus 2,400. All right, this load right here is 7,500 pounds. All right, and that thing's got a 6,000 pound capacity, but it will pick that up. All right, let's start putting these up in the air. Thank you. compound miter cut figured out for this valley beam. So let's go cut that. Hey, check this out. Okay, thing going across. Look how much faster it goes when he's cutting. All right, look at the thing going across. Kind of wishing I bought a bigger crane because that's as far as that would reach. That needs to go over like 10 feet. See if we can slide it. LVLs are leaving. Thank you.
push it a little bit.
Okay. Gotta go a little more.
Okay.
I got it. It's pretty light now. If you could just slide it.
Get all those rafters cut the same length. That group right there, those are all the same. But I got 5, 6 of them to cut. Let that warm up. Alright, so I'm cutting these off level. So let's be right. Is going to overhang this like, I don't know, a couple inches, and then I'm going to put diamond plate fascia right here. That's going to look really cool. The black wood right here. Okay. Now let's bring that to the other end.
actually short by an inch.
All right, got that welded on there. That's gonna be covered with fascia anyway, so. But standing here, it looks perfect to me. Very cool. Look at that valley, that's pretty cool too. All right, the next thing I want to do here is I want to get a little more support underneath that wall right there, the concrete block wall. It's fine the way it is, but those columns coming down there are adding a bunch of weight, and shipping containers in the corners can handle like unlimited weight, but in the center, not so much. Now that concrete wall I have up there, that is filled solid, so that acts like a beam. On top of the shipping container, I have a C channel form, which I poured 8 inches of concrete on top of that, full of rebar, which is all welded to each other. But I just want to get a column from that C channel to the ground. I'm going to do 3 of them because I'm about to add a ton of weight up there, so I just want to make sure this thing is very much overbuilt. So let's dig some footings right here for some small concrete pours. This is the plate I'll rest the column on. Cody's helping me with my hose here. Do it quick. It gets all the dust out of there. Don't breathe this stuff. I'm not breathing in right now. Thank you. that right there. That way that plate or that column will sit right on that. He finally calmed down. It's level going this way, and this way I have it tilted down ever so slightly so the water will run this way. All right, that's fine. All right, we just gotta do this two more times. Right, Cody? How do you think? How does that look? Does that look good? It passes the lab inspection right here, so we're good. This is hot water. Thank you. wish I had this years ago, because I've mixed so much concrete with one of those barrel mixers, which is so much more work. That was 7 bags in this thing, but it looks like I could have fit more. I'll put the link in the description for this thing. That way I'm not welding through concrete. All right, that looks pretty good. Let's try the next one a little different though with that chute. Let's try this.
Mm-hmm.
How's that concrete taste? Eating some delicious concrete. Yummy. He's eating it. I'll let him eat it. All right, here we are, days later. My roof out of these things. Look how easy that step broke. Thank you. All right, that looks pretty good. The grating, I gotta finish up welding that though. All right, we've been trying with this truck. The roads are all ice. Yeah, we're farther than he's been yet. Go. It's all ice right there. Oh, so close. I wonder if I can get around him and pull him. Alright, that's as far as we got it. This is just so slippery. Alright, let's try to drag these up the hill. I kind of slid into this tree now though. Just trying to pull these out of here. Oh, yep, look at that. They really got to make these auto bodies better. It's so delicate. I don't even care anymore. I just let them get smashed up. It's kind of a joke at this point. It's just tin foil. To move the crane for this next lift, and it barely reaches.
Hold it there for a second.
I got it. It's light now. Let's put the ladder where it's gotta be.
Okay.
Alright, slide it down. All right, for connections on this stuff, so what I'm gonna do is I cut out a bunch of plates like this. That fits right in there nice, and I'll be able to fully weld it, weld across the bottom, weld there. Weld that side, I'll weld the bottom. And usually when people attach I-beams, they only attach them on the web. But I like attaching the flanges too, but that would be a super strong connection. Plus this plate on top of here, this roof is good. This is gonna be the strongest building. For attaching the beams, I'm gonna have triangles. These aren't for this spot, but I'll have triangles that go like that. You know, weld them fully on each side, and I'll also put a plate like that, so the beams will be attached very well. All right, and the next video on this project is gonna be the roofing. So here's the sheets here. 3/16 thick steel plate, 8x20 sheets. And there's a sneak peek of what that's gonna look like. Thank you.